So in this chapter, we'll be looking at decision-making statements. Decision-making statements in the sense, if we want to decide whether a condition is true or not, and based on that output, you want to execute a certain set of line of codes. So if a condition is true, one set of code will be executed. If a condition is false, another set of code will be executed. So this we call it as decision-making statements. So there are certain assumptions which Python programming language assumes that any non-zero and non-null values are always true. So if it is 1, 2, 3 or anything which is non-zero, then that becomes true in the sense of Python. And if it is zero or null, then it is assumed as false. So remember, if the output of a condition is zero or null, then the final result of that statement would be false. And if the output of a condition is non-zero, then the output of that statement would always be true. So following are the decision-making statements which Python provides to us. So first is if statement. We have seen if statement in many examples in our previous chapters. So here we'll be seeing it in detail. So if statement is nothing but that is a Boolean expression. Boolean expression in the sense we are evaluating whether the condition is true or false. So here if you see the example, first we have taken a variable. Now since the variable 1 is equals to 100, 100 is a non-zero value and non-null value. That means if this variable is tested, whether it is true or false, it will always be true because the variable contains a non-zero value and non-null value. Now if you see the example also, we have tested the same here. If variable 1, if this is true, if variable 1 is true, then got a true expression value. Now since 100 is non-zero, always this statement gets printed. So this if block always returns true, and all the statements which are indented in the if block will always be get printed. Next, we have taken the another variable whose value is zero. Now zero or null, if this condition is tested, the value of this output will always be zero. So since this is zero, these two statements will not get printed because we don't have an else block here. And if var2, since this is zero, the control should go to else block. So that is the reason these two statements will not get printed. It will directly come out of the if block and the final statement gets printed here. Next we have if else statement. So here we saw there is only one if condition. That means if this is true, then do this task. Now what about if this is false? That we are going to see here. And we are going to see that by using an else statement. If a condition is true, perform the task inside if block, and if the condition is false, perform the task which is inside else block. So here we have taken a variable num whose value is 3. Now since this is non-null value and non-zero value, so this is true here. Number is greater than or equal to 0. So that is the reason the statement which is inside the if block gets executed here and the output is printed. Now not only one if statement, we can nest these if statements. If first condition is true, then do this. If second condition is true, then do this. If third condition is true, then do the third, then execute the third set of code. If everything else is false, only then come to the else block. In those situations, we can use this elif. Elif is nothing but nested if else statement. So here we are using multiple if statements and a single else statement. So first of all, we have taken a variable num and whose value is 3.4. Now since this value is greater than 0, it will go here, positive number. If this was not greater than 0, then it will go to this statement and compare whether it is 0 or not. If it was 0, then this statement would have got printed. And if it is not greater than 0 and not equal to 0, only then this else statement will get printed. So these were comparison, these were decision making statements in Python.